This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle. Yeah, no, I hear you all. Yes, we read your comments. Yes, we know that mice are not humans. Look, I'm not the one doing the studies, guys. Ask the scientists. Okay, I'll look into it. Why do we use mice for this stuff? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. A lot of the time when we're reporting on science here at DNews, the studies we're reading are done with mice. Mice have been used for more than 100 years in tons of scientific research. Today, the laboratory mouse, or musculus, is used as a human analog in everything from brain disease studies to social interaction studies, cancer, smoking, obesity, genetics, so many things. Scientists are using mice because they are small, they're easy to care for, and they have a high reproduction rate. Also, their genome has been sequenced, which is pretty important. According to the National Center for Biotechnology Information, there are over 450 inbred strains of white lab mice, which can be selected and customized for specific studies. Mice have similar immune systems and metabolisms to humans, they have been inbred to minimize genetic differences between different mice, and they can be, or have been, genetically mutated so that their DNA more closely mimics ours. Overall, researchers generally accept mice are good stand-ins for humans. But as medicine drills deeper into the genetic code, they've discovered that even though our DNA looks the same on the surface, mice are still very different. It's already known that humans and mice share 70% of the same protein-coding gene sequences, and about half of their DNA overall. But a new study that'll be a part of a series of papers in Nature, Science, and Genome Research found that some key variances in the way that mouse and human genes regulate are really important. More specifically, they found that a mouse's immune, metabolic, and stress response systems behave differently than a human's at the genetic level. Scientists had been operating under the assumption that mouse genes and human genes would express the same way. But even though the genes appear to accomplish the same tasks, they did those tasks in a slightly different way, like taking a different road to the same destination. And in science, that little detail matters a lot. Now, let's not all start laughing at science or assume that all of the studies ever done on mice are now invalid lies. That is simply not the case. Mice and humans are still similar enough to go along with, but as medicine probes deeper and gets more person-to-person specific, the gene expression of each person is going to affect how they're treated, and it's the same with mice. And knowing the key differences in how mice and human genes work is going to affect how they'll create future treatment. As researchers say, the mouse continues to be a very good model for humans. Now they just need to fine-tune all their experimentation, because 95% of all medical experiments use these genetically modified lab mice. As we often say, more research is needed to see which studies will have to be redone, if any, using this new information. And luckily for us, the researchers promise that there will be more than a dozen new studies on the mouse in the coming years. This is going to be super interesting. But how do you feel about science using mice in the first place? How do you feel about studies like this? Go ahead down into the comments, let us know what you think, and check out Julian's video over here on invisible mice, which is pretty cool. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching. This episode of DNews was brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.